That said, we're now at a time where we have a little bit, things are have settled slightly, and we have a little bit of time for reflection. We'd like to share some of them. We're very, very excited to have a very diverse panel here that will share perspectives from every part of the ecosystem.
It's launched this app, SmitteStop, to trace unknown contacts. So that was also a priority. And it was a priority very early on in the system that we wanted to work with tracking. And I called Jesper and I said, I get all these calls from Danish companies and foreign companies, and they want to work with exposure notification and contact tracing. And Jesper, he said, well, but for now, we don't think the technology is good enough, and the recommendation from the authorities is keep your distance. So be careful what you communicate, and be careful how you enter this field. So we want to strengthen and reinforcing existing priorities using channels that we know, competences and contacts that we know. So we cannot do something all new in the midst of a crisis, but we can take the efforts that we have in place and try to reinforce them and accelerate.
First of all, I want to thank all of you for unique development of new technologies within healthcare, which I'm sure will help patients to have better life in the future. Whoever you are, a healthcare service worker, an employee at the state, a developer of new technology, an excellent engineer, please, please, please don't forget the patient perspective. Thank you.
How the pandemic made me blatantly aware that we need to change the way we treat people with chronic kidney disease. Home therapies have proven over and over again they are much more efficient. Patients feel much better when treating at home because they can get better treatment, it's much more sanitary, and that leads to spending less days in the hospital for complications. Time for innovation in this field is long overdue.
One ambition for us in the regions is that we would like to have an open discussion of things that are invented in one place and is working there. We can actually scale that in 1 week, as we saw. And sometimes we have a lot of discussion on that and a lot of analysis being done before we actually scaling things. We would like to be better on that when it's proving, when the concept of proving one place to scale it faster.
Yeah, maybe I can follow up on that. I think Denmark is a really good country for innovation. When I speak with other startups in, for instance, the US or even just going to Germany, they have a really hard time getting access to the clinics, to getting access to the clinicians, and testing out their very novel, very untested solutions in a real clinical context. We don't have that challenge in Denmark. It's very easy for us to contact you and say, hi, can I install this in one patient room and see how that goes? And from my experience, you often say, yeah, let's try it out. What harm can it do? And we get immense learnings from that when we innovate and doing this, which means that we can move really fast. And I think from this COVID crisis, there's come a lot of even more openness to new innovations from also the more administrative part of the public sector, and a lot of funding as well, which enables the speed of these innovation technologies to go to market faster. What is still lacking is, of course, as you say, it needs to be proven. We need to look into products that already have proven that they work, and this is just a time factor. You can't put money on that. It just takes time and data to see that it's valid. So that will be the challenge from now on, is to have all of these new COVID technologies to prove that they work, so that the public sector in the future is also confident in actually making it a part of the normal operation.
And I think also with technology, I mean, Helle, maybe you can comment on that, but I think that actually using the technology is a big part of learning. It's not just having it, it's about using it and developing that tacit knowledge that I think is really crucial if we as a society is going to be first movers in digital healthcare. Thank you.
Yeah, maybe just a comment on that. I really hope that our mindset in the future could be that one test is better than 1,000 opinions. And actually, one of the things we have discussed with the general practitioners for a while is that could we have like hubs, some different general practitioners all over the country who are willing to try out things, because we know that some of them are really enthusiastic. Where we maybe put some more money, where we also evaluate and get all these first proven projects, we will really like that idea.
I also really much hope that we'll stay ambitious, not only replace the physical meeting with a video consultation, but take the chance to use these new technologies to improve health in the society. So for my cancer patients, I hope that e-health technologies will help improve survival, will improve quality of life, and not only be technologies which replace the care we give today and keep the quality on the level it is. We should use these new technologies to improve quality within healthcare. That's the really beauty of it.
But also coming back to the budgets, I also really think that it's important to change how we look at prevention. Because most COVID-19 products that have come out now from all these investments are preventive focused. Well, if we go back to where we were before COVID, then all of that would just be dropped on the floor and that investment will be a waste of money.
So to make that point, to really, so that we put, you know, what are the solutions that we have, how are they relevant in terms of the problems that are out there and that are acknowledged by decision makers, and then on the other hand, also educating decision makers into understanding what is technology and what can technology do. Like what Helle said, it's not just about moving one task from the hospital into the home or from the hospital into the local municipality. It's about changing, transforming the caregiving itself and giving competences to people working with this in everyday situations and empowering both patients and everyday healthcare workers. For us to have a discussion with you, this network-based interaction, I think it's really fruitful and like always, I'll be, you know, we've had a discussion here and this is going to do something in my head, and thank you there. Yeah.
And we're looking forward to take it from discussion to action.
Exactly.
As well.
Oh, that's my point always.
How do you see the role of technology combating inequality in health? How have so far the learnings from COVID-19 brought new perspectives to this?
Yeah, I would say that it's something that we are still exploring in. And if you saw the political agreement we just did before this summer, there will be an emphasis on inequality and digital inclusion in the coming year. We will look more into this field because we know that both sides, there are some that we are not seeing, that we are missing. But on the other hand, we are also reaching out to people that we didn't reach out to before. As I mentioned, within psychiatry, we see quite an interesting result from video consultation, virtual consultations within the field of young people, but also those with post-traumatic stress syndrome. So I think it's both-sided, and it's much more, it's something that we really have to look more into.
And if I can just add to that, that I also think what is interesting here is that the COVID situation have put emphasis on inequality. Mm. I don't think we have solutions concrete yet, but at least now the conversation is stronger on how technology can help.
Yes, the beauty of these technologies is that they might change resources, so we are able to replace resources from those able to care for themselves to those really needing the care. But you know, the healthcare system has to be brave and go away from this model where everyone has to have the same service. Those who need service, they are going to get the service, and e-health can help us to replace resources to those who really need it.